delighted to have you here. My name is Cathy Gormley-Heenan, as the Vice-Chancellor has said, and as Pro-Vice-Chancellor for Research and Impact here, I'd like to echo Paddy's very warm welcome to all of you to this, the fifth annual Build Peace Conference. And as Paddy said, we're delighted to host the conference for the first time here in Belfast, because as I'm sure you've all gathered already by now, peace building is absolutely rooted within Northern Irish history, and it's just part of our everyday lives. Everywhere that you look, you'll just see and feel the activities of peace building that go on in this city. And that's because our very troubled past has taught us vital lessons as a society about how we need to move together forward and how we need to create a peaceful future for everyone who lives here. Now, our university is a world leader already in peace building, in conflict resolution, and in transitional justice, as well as in the fields of creative industries and in data analytics, all of those things being really important for the conference that you're about to embark upon. And we're the largest university on the island of Ireland. We have over 25,000 students and 2,500 staff. And we're very proud to be ranked this year, again, in the world's top 150 young universities. We're a young university. We don't celebrate our 50th birthday until 2034. And anyone who knows me knows that I love a party, so I'm already preparing for that birthday party, even though it's some years away yet. And Paddy said that I talk a little bit about the research of the university and how it connects with the conference that's on here. So I hope you'll indulge me for a couple of minutes while I wax lyrical about some of the really outstanding achievements that we've had here. We're very much a research-led university, and that means that our excellence in research is a number one priority for us. And over the years, we've been really successful in building an international reputation for research excellence in peace building and in creative industries particularly. And we're in the top 25% of universities in the UK for our research PAR. Our Transitional Institute, the School of Law, the research impact of the law research that's undertaken in transitional justice is first in the UK. In our research endeavours, we really recognise, as Paddy has already said, the importance of creating impact from our research through engagement and partnerships. And that's evidenced through our research institutes who collaborate with government, industry, and the third sector, as well as many people from the community and voluntary sector as well. And you heard Paddy mention our very close relationship and our partnership working with our colleagues in North Belfast. One big example of this, and you'll know already, our globally recognised International Conflict Research Institute, which we know as INCOR, it celebrated its 25th birthday this year. We had a big party for that one as well. And that supports our policymakers as well as practitioners working within communities and civil societies. And the research that INCOR undertakes looks at the context where societies who are confronting the histories of violence, division and discrimination, and abuses of power, and associated policy challenges with all of those things in regions including the Balkans, Central Asia, the European Union, North America, the Middle East, South America, the South Pacific, Southern Africa. I'm not quite sure where INCOR doesn't work. We are engaged with policymakers and practitioners quite across the globe. And that's complemented by other areas within the university, like our art and conflict research cluster, which embraces world-leading research that makes the link between specific conflicts and transferable research outcomes. So the research in this area of art and conflict focuses on landscapes and contested spaces, focuses on art and social cohesion and how art can be used to build social cohesion, looks at art and crises as well as art and the visual documentation of societal disharmony. I've already mentioned our Transitional Justice Institute, which is internationally recognised as a leading academic centre in developing the field of transitional justice. And broadly speaking, that's the study of law and societies emerging from conflict and repression. And our Transitional Justice Institute places research emanating from Northern Ireland, so taking all that we know from our experiences in Northern Ireland at the forefront of local, global, academic, legal and political debates. So when we talk about locally relevant and globally significant, our Transitional Justice Institute is a perfect example of that, of taking the experiences of the local and then making them relevant for the global. To move away from the social science side of things towards the arts side again, we're really delighted to be able to announce that we've had a £13 million cross-sector creative partnership funded recently by the Arts and Humanities Research Council called Future Screens NI. And that's a collaborative partnership with our colleagues in the other university in South Belfast, Queen's University of Belfast, and local industry partners. And that partnership in creative industries will create 3,000 new jobs over the next 5 years right here in Northern Ireland. It's the largest single investment in the creative industries in Northern Ireland. And bear in mind that much of our creative industry work is connected to the subject of peace and conflict. We really do thrive on interdisciplinary research, and I'm delighted that looking at the content of the conference and the range of people that are here today, that it has attracted so many disciplines, that we've delegates here from social policy, from law, from technology, from art and design and psychology, among many, many others. So what we have in the room today is the embodiment of what Ulster University is all about, a truly interdisciplinary endeavour. And of course, while this is very important and really interesting for me on a professional level, peace building is an area of personal interest to me. I go to so many events for the university and launch so many conferences and events on things like nanotechnology and integrated bioengineering or stratified medicine or personalized medicine. And I get by and I know enough, but it's not my area of expertise. So I am absolutely in my comfort zone at this conference today as a professor of politics with research interests in the areas of political elites and peace processes and the politics of divided societies. And some of my own work over the last number of years has looked at peace walls and explored the challenges of the removal of the peace walls that still exist in the Northern Ireland context, almost 50 years after the creation of the first peace wall in Northern Ireland, which some of you may get the opportunity to see on one of the walking tours. When the first peace wall was built in Northern Ireland in 1969, the Army General who was overseeing the construction of the wall at the time said to the BBC camera crew that were there interviewing him at the time of the construction, "Don't worry, it will be down by Christmas." He didn't say which Christmas, and the 50th anniversary is next year. And at this point in time, across Central Europe, there are now more walls and barriers than there were at the height of the Cold War. So the subject of peace walls, barriers, separation fences, and other ways in which to divide and segregate communities and populations is something that's very important to me personally, and something that you can still see real resonance of in the city here today. So the focus of the conference is really close to my heart, and I'm delighted that we're able to host the fifth International Build Peace Conference. But what I'm most delighted about is how we're able to showcase the university, and we wouldn't have been able to do that without the fantastic team at Ulster who've been working with the Build Peace team. Brandon Hamber, Duncan Morrow, Tim Brundle, and of course Maria Prince, who has put together everything so beautifully and so effortlessly. And as I came in this morning and looked at the range of exhibitions downstairs, I thought, this has been done to perfection. So to our team at Ulster, I want to pay a particular thanks on behalf of everyone here. Now, I hope you all have a wonderful time at the conference and that you really enjoy your stay in Northern Ireland, particularly for those of you who've come to Northern Ireland for the first time. And if you do get an opportunity to go and look at that wall that is standing almost 50 years as a manifestation of the past, please take the opportunity to go and do that. Thanks very much.
Thank you, Cathy.